I'm Mohan Menon. I used to work with the Wawasan Open University. Of course, at the moment, I'm retired from there and completing the project. The area of open educational resources last 15 years, has been mostly focusing on the creation of OER. Thanks to the support coming from different foundations, we have created a lot of OER materials, resources. However, the very little has been done in the area of reuse of these resources. And as an educationist, we always felt that it's important that the available resources are used. Then we found that there are problems, or there are the processes involved in reusing a large number of OER seems to be a not very easy process. So there is a need to study these processes. The main research question was to understand to what extent it's easy or difficult in using these materials and the processes involved. What are those processes involved in finding, reusing these materials for developing a new course? The Wawasan Open University, Malaysia was the main site. We also included institutions from India for the course development part, and for tryout we also had the Open University of Sri Lanka. So there are three countries involved. The methodology was an exploratory case study with mixed methods approach, where we have collected both qualitative and quantitative data from the search team who searched for the OER, and also the course developers, and then the people who went through the course material in the tryout process, and the findings we took into account the data collected from all these, so in a triangulation approach was followed for understanding the whole processes. We found that the OER resources were available for the course that we were working on, that was on research methodology in education, and enough materials were available, and large number of them were having open licenses, but the formats were different. A number of them were PDF and HTML, but there are also good resources which were not open. They were open access, but couldn't be reused for purposes of course development. That was one major finding. But when it comes to the reusing the materials, it was not an easy process. The course developers did require certain competencies to develop to use these resources for the new course, developing a new course. And these competencies included a set of core competencies as well as generic competencies. The core competencies were the subject expertise itself, and then OER awareness, the OER expertise in reusing materials, certain skills are involved in that, and also a good understanding of the learning environment, the learning environment for which the course is being developed. And the generic competencies were IT skills and communication and language skills. The findings also included looking at the quality assurance process that we used in developing the course materials. It was found that while reusing OER resources or OER, it was important to follow a number of quality assurance processes to make sure that the course developed is of quality, both from the learner's point of view and from the from other users' point of view. So it did take time to do that. It is not always very easy or less time taken to use the materials, but as we have to have the course, the quality assurance mechanism, it was important that we go through the entire process, and that it take time. And secondly, that the cost, if you look at the cost efficiency, yes, availability of resources did, and it was available very easily from the resource, from the web. So that did, that took less time. And as but as there are a number of ways that we are using it, the cost efficiency cannot be, we cannot say really that, you know, it is easier and took less time to develop that. Maybe over a period of time it becomes more cost efficient because you can reuse the material and develop it further, or even modify these, revise these materials later, and without any further cost on the materials. Yeah, one of the main recommendations is that all the course developers who want to use OER will have to be, should have that capacity to do that. I think those competencies which we found were required, I think there is a need to develop those competencies so that any institutions can really make use of OER more effectively. Secondly, that this is, it's more important that we have the OER practices, open educational practices are adopted in the institutions, rather than only looking at as using resources.